All right, let's go over adding rational expressions that have a common denominator. So first of all, recall from adding fractions with a common denominator that are from arithmetic, if you had 3/11 plus 2/11, imagine if you had a pie into 11 pieces, you had 3 pieces plus 2 more pieces, you would have 5 of those pieces. So 5/11. So basically what you do is if you have a common denominator, you only write the common denominator down once and you add the numerators. So in general, if you have A over D, some denominator, plus B over some other denominator, you just add the numerators and it's all over D, and you simplify if you can. Let's just do an example with numbers. Let's say you have 1/12 plus 5/12. So since the denominators are the same, you could add 1 plus 5, which is 6/12, and then you could reduce. Now 6 goes into both of these numbers, so if you divide the top and bottom by 6, you would get 1/2. So at the end, you would reduce, and remember, one way of reducing is by factoring. So if you had 6/12, one way of reducing is you write 2 times 3 over 2 times 2 times 3 and cancel the common factors. And remember, there's always a 1 left in the numerator if nothing else. They both cancel, so you have a 1 over 2, another way to get 1/2. We're going to use exactly the same procedure, but we're going to have algebraic denominator. So we're going to have some variables, possibly. Here are a couple of examples. In the first one, I have a common denominator of 2x squared. Remember, we do not add the denominators. We just write the denominator down. You have to have the same denominator, and then you simply write it down, and you add the numerators. So 5 plus 7 is 12 over 2x squared. Now, you have to see if you can cancel. And 2 goes into 12, so we're going to have a 6 up at the top. So our final answer here is going to be 6 over x squared. Okay, let's look at this next one. I have a common denominator, so it's all going to be over x squared minus 4. So we take the numerators and add them. So we have 2x minus 3 plus x plus 5. Alright, so what does that give me? If I add like terms in the numerator, I have 3x plus 2 over x squared minus 4. Now the question is, can this be reduced? Keep in mind, you may not cancel the 2 and the 4 because these are full factors. And so if you can factor, you do that. Well, the top, 3x plus 2, you can't factor that because there's no common factor. It's not a difference of two squares. But the denominator can be factored. And so now you look and see, are there any common factors that you can cancel? And the answer is no. So, you could leave your answer either way. I would usually take off the parentheses here in the first one. So, this is a perfectly acceptable answer. Or, you can write it this other way if you want to factor it and leave it. That's really up to the teacher whether they want you to leave it, the numerator and denominator, simplified or in factored form, or either way. Here's another example. The denominators are the same. So I can write it all over the same denominator, 2x squared minus 5x minus 12, and then add the numerators. So I have x plus 1 plus x plus 2. So this gives me 2x plus 3 in the numerator. And the denominator is 2x squared minus 5x minus 12. Again, you may not cancel the 2s, you can't cancel the x's, you can only reduce, cancel, if the numerators and denominators are factored and there's a common factor you can cancel. So I need to see if I can factor to see if anything cancels. Well, 2x plus 3 can't be factored, so I'm going to leave that as 2x plus 3. And what about the denominator? Well, you can do this on scratch paper. There's so many different ways for factoring the trinomials here, the quadratic trinomials. So you might try that on your scratch paper. Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to guess, well, heck, maybe 2x plus 3 is a common factor. So I'm going to see if 2x plus 3 is a factor. So that's going to be my trial factor that I'm just going to try first. Let's see if it happens to work. So 2x times what would give me 2x squared? X. And 3 times what will give me negative 12 minus 4. And let's see if that is the correct factorization. Doing the FOIL method, I have 2x squared minus 8x and plus 3x. Nice. Gives me negative 5x and minus 12. So if you think like the person who wrote the book, you might try 2x plus 3 as a factor. Now, if you try 2x plus 3 and it doesn't work, think about this. Then, however it factors, you're not going to be able to cancel it with that 2x plus 3 anyway. So it's a good idea to try that first, and then you know it's not going to cancel anyway, even if it factors some other way. So here we go. We're going to cancel the 2x plus 3s because it's a common factor. So my final answer here is 1. Remember, there's always a 1 when you cancel everything in the numerator. Don't forget there's a 1 there in the numerator. 1 over x minus 4. What if you had added some problem and you ended up with x plus 5 over 2x squared minus 5x minus 12, and you want to know if anything would cancel? Well, in the numerator, you'd only have an x plus 5. So unless there's an x plus 5 in the denominator as a factor, you can't cancel. So you'd say, well, is it even possible to have an x plus 5 in the denominator? Well, you'd have x times 2x to get 2x squared, but 5 times what is negative 12? Not going to work. So even though this denominator factors, so this is not the correct factorization, x plus 5 is not a factor. Even though this factors to something else, we already know that this is going to be as far as we could go. All right, so you could go ahead and factor for fun, right? But you're not going to be able to cancel anything since x plus 5 isn't going to be one of the factors in the denominator. So it's always a good idea to try factoring it, but just keep in mind, if it factors and nothing cancels, then just go back to your previous way of writing the answer, x plus 5 over 2x squared minus 5x minus 12. Here's another one for you to try. So go ahead and put it on pause and try this problem and then come back. Okay, we have a common denominator of y plus 2, so I'm just going to write the y plus 2 down once and add the numerators. Resist the temptation. You may not cancel the 2 and the 16 here or over here, or the 2 and the 8. Can't cancel the y's. Remember, only if it's factored can you cancel. I can't stress that enough. Now, we want to see if we could factor the numerator and denominator to see if there's a common factor. Well, from 8y plus 16, there's a common factor of 8. So we could pull out a y plus 2. And y plus 2, you can't factor any further, so that's a y plus 2. So I can just cancel the y plus 2s. Now, even though there's a 1 in the denominator, 8 over 1 is going to be the same thing as 8. You want to leave your answer as simplified as possible, and 8 over 1 is the same thing as 8. So the answer to this problem would be 8. Here's one last example for you to try. Put it on pause, try it, and then come and see how you did on it. Okay, we've got a common denominator, so we just write the denominator down once. That's the denominator. Then we add the numerators. So we have 3x minus 1 plus 7 minus 2x. All right, so that gives, well, adding like terms, we have a 3x and a minus 2x, that's x. And a negative 1 plus 7 is plus 6 over x squared plus 5x minus 6. Okay, now we need to see if I'm going to be able to factor that denominator and get this x plus 6 to cancel. I'm going to guess that's one of the factors. Remember, this is a guess. If it doesn't work, it's not. So we have x to get x squared, and we're going to have a minus 1. Yes, it works. That is the correct factorization. So the x plus 6 is cancel, and the answer is 1 over x minus 1. Okay, the next video goes over how to subtract when you have a common denominator. Have fun!